Hi everyone, I'm David.
And I'm Leah, and this is Wine Forecaster.
We got home from work today, and we decided to go down into the cellar and open a bottle of wine.
One of the best things to do after a day's work.
Yeah. So we picked out a wine that we actually bought a few years ago. It's from a winery out in the Finger Lakes, of course. It's from Three Brothers Winery. It's their sub-winery called Bagg Dare.
Yeah.
And the name of the wine is?
Bone Dancer.
It's
a point Pinot Blanc. Mm-hmm. And the winery is on Seneca Lake?
Yep.
And it's, three wineries, a cidery and a brewery.
So, we visited them, I think, 2 years ago. Went down there and checked that out.
Yeah.
Okay, so, but anyhow, we don't always, buy wine, bring it home and drink it right away. I mean, we have a wine cellar, so sometimes we stock up on different bottles. And this was one that we purchased and put down for a couple of years, and we thought that tonight would be a good day or a good evening to open it. So we've been tasting it already and smelling and drinking and stuff like that. We want to talk to you today actually about something called wine futures. One of our viewers wrote into us a few weeks back, and he had some questions about wine futures. And so we thought we'd share that some information with you.
Yeah, absolutely. So say there's a wine that you really like, and maybe they sell out of it quickly, and year after year it's a great wine. So why not invest in that? And certainly that's something that a lot of us, once you identify that, you want to hang on to it. Mm-hmm.
And sometimes also, wines will become more valuable, and you might want to buy it ahead of time to capture a lower price point before it's released, before that price goes up.
Yep.
You see wine futures a lot with French wines like Bordeaux and Burgundy. That's probably, where the biggest bang for the buck is with wine futures. And you don't really see it too much in the Finger Lakes, but you've mm-hmm. discovered a few futures that were available.
Yeah, and they're basically through wine clubs in the Finger Lakes. So you'd have to go to your particular winery and see if they have any club stuff, and then if they also offer any futures.
Mm-hmm.
So you're paying, or you're at least ordering ahead of time.
At a lower price point.
At a lower price point, which is awesome.
Now, if you ever want to explore wine futures in general, for wines around the world, probably your best bet would be to explore that online. Or if you go to some of your wine stores, you can discuss that with the manager there and see if they offer contracts for wine futures.
Yeah.
So that's the best way. But like I said, you can do this online as well. There's a lot of large internet wine companies based in New York or Chicago or other large cities that offer wine futures. So, but this was not a wine future, was it?
No, it wasn't.
So, but we are drinking it in the future from when we bought it.
Yeah.
So what do you think of the wine?
Well, first impression of the nose is it almost smells a little bit like a sweet Band-Aid.
Yeah, I kind of smell that too. It had a lot of mustiness to it. Once you taste the wine, you really can't appreciate that again. But
yeah, but it has a citrus.
A little bit.
A little bit of a grapefruit component to it.
I didn't really like the nose too much, but after I tasted the wine, it had a little bit more. I like the flavor of it. It is definitely sweet, but not too sweet. It could be a little more crisp.
Yeah, I would agree that the acidity, it's there, but you need to have a little bit more of a punch, and I don't know if that's because of the Pinot Blanc or not, varietal.
Yeah.
It could be.
I doubt things changed too much from us keeping it in the cellar. It's only been in there for a couple of years.
Okay.
So, and usually, once it's in the bottle and it's laid down, this type of wine, it really isn't going to improve at all. It should last a long time because of the higher sugar content.
Yeah.
So I'm almost done. I have to have a refill.
A refill. Yeah. We haven't even had dinner yet.
No, you haven't even touched your wine. But anyhow, so we just want to touch upon this wine in general. It's no longer available. They do have some sort of Gewürztraminer. I called the winery up, and apparently there is a Gewürztraminer dessert wine that is replacing it, or some sort of wine. So you can look that up online and see. They do offer a whole lot of different wines through their different establishments there. So
it's Three Brothers Winery.
Right. So and if you haven't been down to Seneca Lake, it's an interesting place to explore. It certainly
Absolutely.
Is. Great. It would be you could spend a few hours down there.
You could. In the warm weather.
Yeah.
Especially.
All right. Well, so look them up, and we'll put the wine down. I don't know if you'll be able to find any more of this here. So this could be the last sip of this wine for eternity.
Cheers.
Cheers. So, all right. Well, thanks for joining us today. We look forward to seeing you for our next video. I'm David.
And I'm Leah. And this is Wine Forecaster.